Hej derude, og velkommen til denne uges udgave af Hobro IK Live, vores nyhedskanal på Periscope, hvor vi fortæller alt omkring Hobro IK Superliga-hold. Du har mulighed for at præge udsendelsen ved at stille spørgsmål til os, og vi skal gøre det bedste for at besvare de mange spørgsmål. Mit navn er Ole Kirker Christensen, jeg er pressechef i Hobro IK, og ved min side i dag, der har jeg Quincy Antipas, og vi håber selvfølgelig, at der vil komme rigtig mange spørgsmål til Quincy. Men vi lægger ud, og det foregår på den måde, at jeg stiller spørgsmålene på dansk til Quincy, og så svarer Quincy på engelsk, og I stiller selvfølgelig også spørgsmålene på dansk derude. Quincy, jeg vil starte med at spørge dig. Du har ikke spillet en kamp siden den 1. maj, da vi tabte i Aalborg, og du blev skadet i ugen efter.
Ja.
Kan du prøve at beskrive, hvad skete der ved træningen, da du blev skadet?
Oh, it was a tackle on my ankle during a training session, and I got hit on my ankle. Now I've been trying to recover from that more or less. And it was quite a hard hit, so yeah, that's where we are now.
Der er nok mange, der vil spørge, at de husker Andreas Cornelius, der blev skadet. På et tidspunkt, der lå omkring dit skadestidspunkt.
Yeah.
Og han er tilbage nu og scorer mål for FCK. Hvorfor tager det så lang tid at komme over sådan en skade?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a doctor, but from what I've been told is the problem mainly being that it's easier to maybe break your ankle and that you recover from that faster, because you know specifically after the break it will be a certain amount of weeks to recover. But I'm in the zone where you get hit, where you have a bruise and there's still a lot of inflammation and fluid in that region, so it takes time. That's what I've been told by the doctors. But I've been getting a lot of treatment at Pro Treatment in Copenhagen, and they've been helping me a lot, so I've progressed quite a bit. But also I know that the doctor this idea in Hobro, Tom and Rasmus, they've explained that it takes time, so not much more I can do about it.
So vi må vente lidt endnu, før vi skal se dig på banen.
Yeah, I hope so. It's soon, but yeah.
Hvordan er altså det med at sidde udenfor i 5 uger, undskyld 5 måneder? Hvordan takler man det rent mentalt, det at ikke kunne spille fodboldkampe? Det må vel være hårdt.
Yeah, it is difficult. I mean, this is probably my longest injury I've ever had in my career. So it has been an experience for me, but at the same time, I also learned that that's part of life. You know, you these situations come up, you do what you can. Just to try and be ready when you are ready, but I think everyone goes through a period of time when they go through these things, and that's life. I mean, I'm still walking, breathing, and I'm still alive. You know, I'm still grateful for what I have. So you know, but you get to appreciate what you do for a living a lot more. So it's made me miss football quite a bit actually, and I'm hungry to get back.
Nu er der sket det i mellemtiden, mens du har været ude med skade, at vi har fået nogle flere spillere fra Afrika. Vi har to af dine landsmænd fra Zimbabwe. Vi har en spiller fra Mali og en fra Senegal. Hvad betyder det for dig, at der er flere afrikanske spillere i klubben?
I can practice more languages now, so that's fantastic.
Okay.
I can work on my French, so because Tidian and Tambura speak French, so it's perfect. I'm trying to learn a bit of Korean as well. So. No, I think it's good for the. It's obviously. Puts Hobro in a new perspective. First time to have so many foreign players from different continents. I mean, I think that's a first for Hobro. So it's a good thing, you know, in terms of that Hobro's trying to open their market. Mm. You know, trying to look in a different way. You know the environment in Hobro is not as similar to other clubs. They don't have a massive youth system. So I guess they're trying to find the right opportunities for the right price. And it's hard work, but good work from the buying department.
Nu er der begyndt at tage spørgsmål ind, og et af spørgsmålene lyder, hvilken rolle du forventer at få på holdet, når du vender tilbage.
My role as in the where I play or
yeah, I think position maybe.
I don't know. My job is just to make things happen.
Make things happen. And yeah. That is
I'm the go-to man when things need to happen.
So you are satisfied as long as you can be in the start 11.
I don't think that will be a problem. My point is that I think I know if when I'm back in shape, I'll play a key role in helping the team stay up. And and now I'm not just focusing on anything else, but just getting back into shape. And that's all I can do now. So I'm not thinking so much on what's in the future. I have to think about now and every day right now.
Men hvis vi prøver at følge op på det spørgsmål, så er det et spørgsmål om, at konkurrencen på holdet er blevet stærkere. Vi har fået en bredere og dygtigere trup. Og hvad betyder det for dig, at du bliver mere...
It's good for the squad. It's good for guys to that you're going to play with. You know, it brings up the level in the team, you know. You know, but I mean, I always know myself when I'm in the best shape. I know what I can do.
En anden ting, som vi godt kunne tænke os at høre lidt om, det er et projekt, du har hjemme i Zimbabwe, et fodboldprojekt. Kan du prøve at beskrive, hvad det går ud på?
Actually, I'm not disclosed to talk too much about that. That's the problem, because there are certain things that we're working on with the club. So I think it would be better for me to hold on with that until everything's in place, more or less, if you know what I mean.
Okay, det venter vi så med at tale om. Det vi i stedet for kan tale om, det er den kamp, vi skal spille på lørdag mod Esbjerg. Og undskyld, mod Randers, det var Esbjerg, vi spillede mod i mandags.
Are you still angry about the Esbjerg game? Are you still angry?
Jeg vil komme over det efterhånden. Men nu venter Randers på lørdag. Og vi har to ude med karantæne. Brix Damborg og Thomas Hansen. Se ud fra Quincy, hvordan tror du vores muligheder er i den kamp?
Man, I think if you look at our team now, we've got Chon Lund out and Tambura's come and done a great job. He hasn't trained the team much. And then you look at, okay, you're saying Dumbo is out and who else?
And Hansen.
The center back, right? Yeah. So if you look at it, okay, we have a direct replacement there as Casper Paulsen. So, I mean, those are twins, more or less. You can't really put a difference between them. And maybe in the center back, we just have to hopefully find someone to fill. And I'm sure, you know, the team will figure out a solution regarding that. But I think it's still we still have a chance in like every game. Last time, I think we played runners, we had we had a lot of injuries. And I think a lot of suspended players, right? And we won 1-0. And that was with, not as strong a team as we have now. So I think people know that we stand a good chance, no matter what.
Og vi skal lige sige til alle jer, der ser med derude, at det vi sender lige nu, det er Hobro IK Live. Det handler om fodbold, det handler om Hobro Superliga-hold, og vi har Quincy Antibas i studiet her på DS Arena. Og I er meget, meget velkommen til at stille spørgsmål. I stiller spørgsmål på dansk, og Quincy svarer på engelsk, hvis det er spørgsmål til Quincy. Ellers så har vi også lidt nyt omkring landsholdsudtalelser. Alexander Nybo og Gøtjen Kaja er blevet udtaget til Danmarks U20-landshold og skal med i den trup, der tager til Horsens og møder Sverige i en træningskamp. Derudover er Adama Tamboura udtaget til Malis landshold, der møder på Burkina Faso. Og derudover så har vi også fået Marion George udtaget til Costa Ricas U23-landshold, men Marion George er forhindret i at spille den kamp. Og jeg kan se, der var et spørgsmål, hvordan vi skal kunne vende tingene. Hvordan formår vi at vende den udvikling, vi er inde i?
I think it's... You got to give credit to the first half we played yesterday on against SPR. That actually showed the level we were on, you know, where we can be. The new guys in the team have now played, what, 2-3 games together, right? Most of the guys. So, I mean, you can actually see that, I mean, we really played a good first half. Whether or not SP played good or bad, you know, we were outstanding in the first half. And more or less it's about, obviously, I think a big part of it is being Anas injured. Anas him and Mass were very good, and we're good defensively because of that. But I think that's been a bit of a difficult situation because Thomas has come and done a good job. But obviously these two have worked together for a long time. So, you know, I think... It's like last year we didn't have so many injuries, so we had continuity, and I think that's the same thing now. Once we have the more or less of the a couple of guys back and get that consistency in again, then the results will follow. I don't think it's something to panic so much about. You know, you can see the amount of energy we put out the last game, and that was actually quite impressive. And unfortunately, with certain issues that didn't work in our way. We lost the game, but I have to look and say that we really have a good chance to progress in the next few games. You know, obviously I'm sure the coaches will also look at certain aspects of changing that. You know, we can see we're also playing a bit differently in the way we counter-attacking, because before we were playing a bit in a way that we had not as fast wingers, and now Kaya and the other guy, Park, and Pal as well, it's giving us a different dimension. You know, we're not playing so many long balls. We're playing more directly out of it over the ground, and you can see we're so much more dangerous. I mean, that you can see the combinations Kaya and all the three up top are making.
Jeg tror egentlig også, det er hvad Jonas har udtrykt, at vi er i en pointmæssig krise, men vi er ikke i en spillemæssig krise. Og så længe vi ikke er i en spillemæssig krise, så har vi mulighed for at hente de her point hen ad vejen.
Yeah, I think you have to look at it like that. What can we say? In the last two games, we may have lost, but we haven't been totally out of the games. And that's an important thing. It's different to get totally smashed out of a game and you know, like, okay, we've been beaten. But it doesn't look like that right now. We look like we're in a position where we still can win games. And sometimes, you know, last year we were, to be honest, we overachieved. We did overachieve. But this year, this is where we have to now try and work for these points, and it will come with time. It always does.
Men der er vel også stor forskel på den kamp vi spillede i Haderslev for 7-8 uger siden, og så de sidste to kampe vi har spillet mod FCK og Esbjerg.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. A lot more energy. I mean, and also at that time you got to understand we played against the Sønderjyske team that's one of the best in Denmark right now. They are unbelievably good right now.
Der var et spørgsmål om hvornår du vender tilbage på fodboldbanen. Folk spørger om du vender tilbage i slutningen af efteråret. Tror du der er en chance for det?
I got my chiropractor and physio at the back there. She's laughing. Rika, I don't know. We're not sure yet.
Rika, can we få Quinty tilbage i efteråret?
We're working on it. I'm working on it hard. With, as I said, I'm a lot in Copenhagen, and the club is pushing me to go everywhere to try and do as much as we can. I know we're working right now as hard as we can to get me back.
Så er der en, der spørger om du forlænger kontrakt med os, men det har du allerede gjort.
Ja. Yeah.
Der er meget bekendt kontrakt frem til 2017.
Ja, og next year, yes.
Ja. Så vi kommer til at se meget mere til dig på fodboldbanen her.
Yeah, of course. That's why I mean I don't expect us to go down this year. There's no thought of that. I don't sign to clubs that go down.
Det er godt at høre. Så er der spørgsmål om hvordan stemningen er i truppen. Og jeg ved ikke om du har et indtryk af det.
It's a bit difficult. I haven't been with the team for a couple of days now. And no, I can see. You know, it seems that the morale is still pretty good. So, you know. I think that's the main part. Everyone still enjoys playing football. So in general, I don't think anyone is looking down. I think people are more angry and just frustrated the last 2-3 days. But I have a feeling that this will turn into hunger for a win the next game. You can feel it that guys are now pissed off. So they want to get the points. So that's a good thing, actually.
Men det er rigtigt. Altså, stemningen var jo rimelig med efter kampen i mandags mod Esbjerg. Alle var selvfølgelig op at køre over den måde, kampen sluttede på. Men vi er videre, og nu venter der en kamp på lørdag, jeg er sikker på, at drengene nok skal gøre, hvad de kan for at få point med hjem fra Randers. Vi kan se, at vi har et minut tilbage af vores udsendelse i dag, så vi skal høre, om der er et allersidste spørgsmål på falderæbet. Så er det ved at være tiden, I skal stille det sidste spørgsmål. Og der kom et her. Der står Mads Wiel, som ser med. Hvordan har han det i Tyskland, og kommer han snart hjem igen? Ja, det er lidt svært for os at svare på, fordi det ved Mads Wiel, som jo er meget bedre end os. Men vi håber da, at Mads Wiel, som en dag vil vende tilbage til Hobro. Men i første omgang, der vil vi gerne ønske Mads stor held og lykke og succes i Tyskland, og så kan det være, at en dag du går op igen på DS Arena. Så hej til dig, Mads, hvis du ser med derude. Det var alt fra Hobro IK Live denne gang. Vi siger tak til Quinty Antipas. Og tak til jer, der så med derude, og vi sender igen næste onsdag kl. 15:30. Tak.